Next, each of us would walk onto the map, put our own mark of where we were born, and then chart the path from there to here. Finally, on our paths, each of us would write a story of our journey so far, what set our course, changed our direction, or sent us running to or from something wonderful or something painful. We would find that some of our paths are short in length. Maybe we have lived our whole lives here in Brooklyn, even in this neighborhood. While other paths are longer, with some of us having come from around the city, across the country, or even over the vast and endless ocean. Our paths would surely crisscross and overlap and zigzag and curl back on each other. We would certainly find that all of our journeys have been rich in experience, some filled with joy and others with tragedy in proportions that we could never fathom. Some of us might even find common experiences. Our valedictorian and I share a homeland, a little country in the Balkans that you may have never heard of, called Bosnia and Herzegovina. My family fled from political persecution there in the 70s, and hers did the same to escape from a very different and unimaginable form of violence and hatred 2 decades later. 2 young girls at the time, 2 decades apart, we have never met until today. But here we are together, here we all are. As you prepare to end the St. Francis College part of your journey, you must ask yourself, what did I learn here? And what of this will I take with me out into the world? You may be bursting to cry out that St. Francis College taught you everything you ever need and you wish you could have stayed longer. Now don't be too quick to respond to that, because some of you do come back. Or maybe you want to shout out that you can't wait to get away and never come back. Either way, whether you like it or not, whether you believe it or not, you will carry St. Francis in every one of your professors and administrators and classmates and roommates and teammates and friends and foes with you for the rest of your life. As a professor of education, I wonder most about what you have learned from us as your professors in the more formal parts of your education, and what of that will serve you in your life to come. I wish that all of your experiences could be perfect, that every course and every one of us inspired you to want to learn more or to just love knowledge for its own sake. That was not always my educational experience. Like many here today, I was the first of my family to go to college, and I had no idea what to expect. Not understanding the nuances of navigating these environments can be very intimidating and a very lonely experience. And looking back now, I suppose I expected professors who cared about us as people and then as students, who took seriously their responsibility, who showed a reverence for teaching and learning, and perhaps above all, who nurtured my understanding of how to learn new things and integrate them into my own sense of who I am. Instead, and for reasons I cannot fully explain, there were those teachers who were indifferent and did their job just like any other, or who saw me and many of us at best as a receptacle for what they thought was important. And I can either let it fill me up or not, it was all the same to them. It's very easy in these instances to become discouraged and disenchanted and at times even humiliated. But here I am doing the commencement address, and I learned to be more resilient along the way. My personal experience as an undergraduate led me to change direction in my own professional life, and I decided I wanted to become an educator, hoping to teach the next generation of teachers how to open their classrooms to a world of possibility. Initially, my goals were modest, creating an empowering classroom experience and promoting a love of learning where we could all take intellectual risks, a place where creativity and innovation abound, a place where we could fall together and rise together. But over time, there was something still unsettled in me, and I realized that I had a much larger responsibility. Finally, in graduate school, I started to understand what that meant when I first read the timeless words of Brazilian educator teaching is to make it possible for the students to become themselves. And with that, one of the questions that you should be asking today is reflect on your time with us at St. Francis. What have we done to help you become yourself? How have your professors helped to prepare you for your own futures? Hopefully, we have taught you a few things that you did not know when you got here, and taught you something about how to think critically, to question, to respect the subject matter of your discipline. Perhaps we helped to prepare you for the working world or inspired you to further your education. Maybe we instilled in you a strength of character, or maybe you just became a more resilient person as a result of your time here. And clearly, that's the case because you're all here today. If we did any of these things, we have at least partially fulfilled our responsibilities of teachers and as artists. But here at St. Francis, we aspire to offer you something else, something unique. You've often heard about the Franciscan spirit during your time here, that sense of hospitality and generosity. It's a part of the spirit and the culture of the school. We're surrounded by it. I think of it as being out here. But for me, it's more than that. I like to think of it as the Franciscan heart. The gift you received here is an education of the heart. And that's something that lives in here. It lives in you, it becomes a part of you, and it enlarges your sense of humanity. It transcends education and time and geography. As St. Francis himself said, remember that you leave this earth, you can take nothing that you have received, but only what you have given. A heart full and enriched by honest service, love, sacrifice, and courage. More than anything else, I hope that it is at least a little of our Franciscan heart that you will take with you, which has nothing at all to do with religion or beliefs or ideology or politics. Rather, it has everything to do with where you are going and what you carry with you along the path. May it always be your compass in the world. When we have finished making our maps and talked about our past and laughed and cried over where we have been and how we got here, we're going to have to start thinking about what's next. The big question that you're all asking yourselves is, where do I go next? What do I do? What will I become? And which direction should I go? How will I accomplish it all? In other words, what is the right path for me? By now you're probably wondering if your humble teacher artist up here will reach deep into her own Franciscan heart, gaze into the future, and tell each of you which path is for you, or at least how to go about it and which direction to go. So I will. In the early part of the last century, the Spanish poet Antonio Machado said, "Traveler, there is no path. We make the path by walking." All of our paths converged here for a while, and we're so grateful to have shared it with you for a short while. And once we finish here today and roll up our map, we will never again all be together in the same place at the same time. So let's cherish this time together here today. And then I want you to walk out those doors and start to make a path, understanding in our own hearts that any path can be wonderful as long as it's yours.